Richie, I got a question for you. So if you had to be, say, the Jane Bunn of forecasting marlin fishing, what would you expect to see happen in the next 2, 3, 4 weeks on that south coast marlin, New South Wales coast marlin that a lot of Victorians are looking forward to and gearing up, getting ready to go? What's your prediction of what's going to happen?
Well, I'll be monitoring the situation now, obviously knowing that I'm going to go in the coming weeks, and obviously want to put my clients on the best possible water to give them the best chance to catch. And it's been a spectacular beginning to January on the marlin. Like, if I don't know if you're across all the marlin, like, I'm, you know, I've got quite a few connections and contacts I've made over the years and friendships and stuff, and we chat just like we're doing now. And the extraordinary bite that they're having up on the Gold Coast, for example, where all this water pretty much starts coming down from, you get that Coral Sea East Australian current that pushes down from up there. And they're probably having one of the best blue marlin, stri marlin bites that they have ever seen.
Yeah.
We talk, the guys are catching, you know, I've heard reports of 18 out of sort of 25, 30 fish for the day. You know, they're good, incredible numbers. And then, you know, you got the water off Newcastle and Forrester and all that sort of stuff. But the one thing that's happening along and is consistent along the way, Sydney, if you know anyone in Sydney, you'll know that some of the Sydney fishermen, like, is pretending like we're going out of Port Phillip Heads. It would be the equivalent of going out of Port Phillip Heads for us.
Yep.
And all the Sydney boats going out of their home waters, and, you know, they're getting 5, 6, 7 marlin out of their home waters, which is, they'll tell you, is normally very, very hard to do. The bait doesn't hold up there and fish just move through, but they're getting consistent results. But probably the one thing that's consistent all that way at the moment is there's not a big congregation of bait. Fish are in that water and they're moving down. The current's moving pretty fast.
Yep.
And so you're having these bite windows that are really hot today and tomorrow, and then probably peter out pretty quickly. And there's good numbers of fish coming down in that water. If I had to predict where it's going to happen in the next 2 weeks, I would put my odds on money that you're going to probably get something around Eden to Marimbula way, and in that zone. That water's starting to warm up. The current's backed off.
Yep.
The bait's starting to stack up there. You know, there's other areas. Bateman's Bay is actually fishing quite well, and there's bait holding there on the inside of the shelf now, and it's been fishing really well, but they're having their on and off days, and the bait can be patchy.
Have you heard much out of Jervis Bay, Richie?
Jervis Bay, that current's ripping really hard through there, but in saying that, the fish are coming through it. And, yeah, there's been some really, really good solid reports coming out of Jervis Bay. But it's one of those places where, you know, you go out today and just they're everywhere, and, you know, you go out tomorrow and they're gone.
Yeah. So to simplify, basically what's happening is we've got the EAC, which is flowing down the east coast of Australia, which is like the Marlin Highway. And it's peak hour at the moment. There's a lot of marlin on that highway. And we're sort of looking for that water to eddy as we reach the south coast, or hopefully as close to us as possible, and that's where the bait's going to stack up, and hopefully there'll be a traffic jam of marlin, and Dreamcatcher will be floating around on top of them, catching them.
I like the way you look at it, man, but that's exactly how you described it as well as you did. That is pretty much it.
Yep.
That is exactly it, where that water slows up and where she starts to mix in, where the bait's going to congregate and the bait's going to hold for any period of time. Those fish are going to slam the brakes on. And it's not that you won't catch fish in other locations, but the fish will hold for longer periods of time and be more consistent fishing over a period of time in those locations. That's what it boils down to.
Absolutely. Now...